everybody, welcome to an Epic My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have the best video that I like to make, honestly. I mean, this is one of my favorite videos of the year to make, and it is the best WWE Elite figures of the year. We do have a couple of Ultimates in here. You know, I'm not going to bullshit with you guys. We do have a couple Ultimates in here. But you know what? I'm not going to do the Ultimates of the year because we only get like five or six of them, so that would be a really short video and dumbass video that no one should make that video. We're not going to make our own separate video for Ultimate figures, but we will include them in this video. But you guys can see here by the mound of figures just the outstanding job that Mattel has done of producing these WWE Elite figures that we love so much. I mean, my God, look at the massive pile right here. If they did not make Epic figures, then I would only have two or three in the video, but they do such a good job, and they have gotten so much better as time has gone on since 2009 or 10, whenever the series started, that we have a massive amount here that I am just appreciative to show off to you guys and showcase and just let you guys know the best WWE Elite figures of the year in my personal opinion. Now, I tried to narrow down the list as the best, you know, as best as I possibly could, but it was really difficult, man. There were so many good ones, and I tried to remember every exclusive. I will say there's probably one or two figures that I probably left out on accident, you know, Walmart exclusive, Target exclusive, or some one-off series that I forgot to include. I'm going to go ahead and apologize for that in advance because you guys know I'll probably miss one, and you guys will definitely assault me in the comment section below, and I will definitely find out about it. So that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to dive in here. I want to give a huge shout out to Ringside Collectibles and Mattel for sending me a lot of these figures and making these figure video possible for covering the WWE Elites of the Year. Thank you so very much to both of them. If you guys want to get in on Ringside Collectibles Black Friday sale, go over there, use the promo code MDTOYS, save 10%, and just let's go ahead and dive into this video, man. Let's get into these figures. So let's start things off, ladies and gentlemen, with the WrestleMania 36 Elite Kofi Kingston. I'm not going to try and spend too much time on one figure because you guys can see by the massive pile, I don't want to sit here for 45 minutes, so let's just shut the hell up and get into the pile. So you guys can see here, it is from his moment where he beat Daniel Bryan for the WWE Championship. I just think this was a really good figure. I will say that the hairline was crappy, but once I fix this, it's not my favorite head sculpt, but I still think the attire and the pink sleeves and everything is freaking wicked nasty farts, so I wanted to include Kofi. Next up, guys, we have an Elite 72 figure, and it is Batista or Batista. And again, it did miss some tattoo details, but a really nice figure. And when I saw this figure at WrestleMania 35, I knew for a fact I wanted to have an Elite of it, so I'm happy that Mattel did give it to us. Next, guys, we have another Elite 72 figure. I think this is Elite 72 Rey Mysterio, and they have done a very good job on the Rey Mysterio Elites this year. I just love them. I love these, like, modern Rey Mysterios in the, you know, the tights like this. I think they're so nice. They're so nice, the freaking posability and the tight joints and the head sculpts and everything, and they just keep getting better, man. So hopefully we continue to get these Rays, and I'm gonna keep getting them and buying them because they're freaking epic. The bicep bands, just perfect Rey Mysterio Elite. Getting into some exclusives, guys, we have the Network Spotlight Gender Football Target exclusive, which is a really good figure. I love the head sculpt on this guy. I will say I'm not big on these arms, like, you know, those modernized arms that we've seen with some Elites in the past. I don't like those arms, but I really like that we got the yellow attire. It comes with the WWE title, black calves. Everything about this thing is nice, man. I really enjoy Gender Football, so I had to include his Elite. Next, guys, I could not remember if the WrestleMania 35 Elites were from 2019. I could not remember it, so I went ahead and included a couple of them here just in case. And we do have the WrestleMania 35 Taker, which is pretty much a release of the Basic 74 or Basic whatever the hell set. What was it? Is it Basic 71 Undertaker head sculpt on the WrestleMania 32 Elite body? And they pretty much release this, and it looks epic, man. What a great figure. I actually prefer the Basic series conversion into an Elite, but I still like this a lot. I like the head sculpt and everything, and I think you guys would agree. This is definitely one of the better Undertaker Elites, if not the best they've ever made. Next up, guys, we have Elite 71 Jeffrey Hardy, and you guys found out that yesterday we're getting a brand new Jeff Hardy Elite, and it is Elite Series 75, and so we're gonna have a brand new Jeff. Won't be until 2020, but I'm sure that figure will go into the 2020 video, but these pink sleeves and the pink face paint and the towel and the interchangeable heads is just uncanny, man. Just great stuff from Mattel with this Jeff Hardy. Moving on, guys, we have the Elite 70 Johnny Football figure to go with our Gender Football figure, and it is a beautiful figure. I think this is easily the best Johnny Gargano. I mean, that's without a doubt. You couldn't debate anybody on that fact. But here you have the beautiful head sculpt. Not our favorite attire, but still an epic attire nonetheless. You know, they did leave off the emoji on the pants, which I have fixed since then, and the lower legs were a bad deal, but they were not a deal breaker because of how epic this figure was. And can you imagine if they made it to a perfect T, then it'd probably be like a top 10 figure. It'd probably be a top 3 figure of the year. That's another thing. If you guys want me to make a top 10 figures of the year or top 10 elites of the year, let me know down in the comment section below instead of just the top figures of the year. But I had to give credit to all these figures, so I did want to make one big video first. So I love that Johnny Football figure. We do have the NXT Target exclusive Aleister Black, which is our first Aleister Black Elite. Looks so very good, man. I love this Aleister Black. It's so freaking beautiful and perfect. I love the head sculpt, the vest, the attire. I know it's just solid black pretty much, but it's still a great figure. Once you fix the height, I think it's freaking perfect. Excellent stuff. I wish that figure was easier to track down, though. Next up is the Elite 72 Becky Lynch with her championship, and I love this figure. I think it's one of my favorite women's elites to date. I love the head sculpt. I think it's pretty much a perfect head sculpt, and once you put the title on there, it's got the leather cloth goods jacket, double jointed knees. The women's figures are on the come up, and this figure had to be included, man. You got the man jacket. Just such a good looking figure, man. Man, I hate myself. Next up, guys, is a Elite 73 figure, and it is the figure that actually came in at the bottom of the tier list as far as the worst to best ranking in our WWE Elite Series 73. If you missed our reviews of all of Elite 73, go check it out. But we have the Elias. I mean, the head sculpt gets it on this list automatically. It's just such a good looking head sculpt. Probably one of the better head sculpts Mattel's ever made, and they only get better. So I had to definitely include Elias. Even though he was at the bottom of our ranking, he had to be included. Next up, guys, we have my man, Roderick Strong, one of my favorite wrestlers in the world, the Elite 72 Roddy Strong. And even with the torso, you know, inaccurate in my own personal opinion, it had to be included. We finally got our Roderick Strong Elite. We had to wait so long for it, but with the North American Championship on it and the shirt and the freaking accessories, I know it didn't come with everything. However, it's still a beautiful looking figure, and I had to include Roddy Strong. And plus, it's the War Games attire, so we're just perfection. Next up, guys, we do have the Alexander Wolf figure, the Collector's Edition, and I could not remember if this was from this year, but I did want to include it. I know that it was a part of Elite Series 65, and Elite Series 65 was the first wave that released in 2019, so I went ahead and included it because technically Elite 65 was a part of 2019, then I had to include this as well. I think I did the same thing with Pete Dunne last year, so I wanted to include him with 2019. Next up, guys, we have the Network Spotlight Target exclusive Asuka figure, and this is fantastic. I know it didn't come with the robe that it was supposed to come with, but it's still a good looking figure, even though it has the diaphragm jiggle wiggle on it. Not a big deal to me. Great looking figure nonetheless. She is looking off to the right or something like that, but I love it nonetheless. Next, guys, we have an Elite Series Neck 60 Flicky Flu. What the hell was I about to say? I don't know. We have an Elite Series Neck 60 Flicky Flu. Elite 69 Ciampa is here in the house, and this is damn near perfect, guys. I know I did put the Bobby Roode legs on it, which makes it perfect, but this is a great figure, and you cannot combat it. It's just like some of the figures in this wave. You cannot debate me on this. Just like Johnny Gargano, I would say, Ciampa is looking fantastic. I mean, it is perfect. It is a perfect figure, especially with the leg swap. Legs are a little bit tiny, but you know what? You switch up those legs. Get out of my face, Brad. Next up, guys, we do have our Ultimate Edition Ronda Rousey, and this figure had to be included. I think I've included this figure with so many videos. This is definitely my favorite women's figure of all time. It's definitely one of my favorite Mattel figures of all time with how nice it is. It's just so great. The double-jointed arms, the double-jointed knees, the accessories, the posability. This figure right here could kick my own ass. I've said it multiple times. I'll just be sleeping in the bed. I will wake up. She'll be making this face at me. Foot of the bed, crawl up the covers, and kick my ass in my sleep. That's how good this figure is. So Rowdy Ronda Rousey had to be included, man. This figure just gets me excited to be a collector. That's how damn good it is. Next up, guys, we do have a couple more Ultimate Editions, and I did want to include it here. We have the early 2000s Triple H, a figure we waited forever on. I still have not switched the torso. I'm not big on this torso. I do not like this torso, but for now, you know, it gets the job done. It hasn't been priority. I've been doing other things, so it hasn't been a priority to switch the torso, but I have heard that it's actually very easy to do so I will be doing that. I think I did add that knee brace there, and we did switch out the knee pad. I can't remember what we did. I think we put it through surgery. I don't know. But regardless, it's a badass looking figure, and again, I wanted to include this Ultimate Edition Triple H. Another Ultimate Edition that could not be left out is the Finn Balor, and again, not big on the torso, but the accessories and the tongue out and the demon paint and the cloth goods and the headgear and just the my, it hurts me. Excellent Finn Balor figure. I love it. It's just so good. I really want a lot of them so I can get a bunch of these heads in here so we can customize them and stuff. The double-jointed arms are fantastic, and I do want to switch out. I think I do want to switch out, like, the torso with, like, a normal Finn and then, like, customize some heads and stuff just to see if I can make, like, my own Ultimate Edition Finn Balor non-demon paint. But we'll have to see about that, but this figure had to be included, dude. What a freaking beast of a figure. here. And I have my Custom Elite from BEW, so it's cool to have that in the collection as well. Next up, guys, is my man Dolph Ziggler, the Elite 70 Intercontinental Championship Dolph Ziggler. And this is a fantastic figure. I know it does have the massive arms and everything. They did leave off the black outsoles on the boots, but this figure is perfect. To me, I think the head sculpt is nice. I know that once you do the basic arm swap and you do paint the black boots and everything, it makes it even better. But it had to be included. I just love this head sculpt so much. I know a lot of people don't really like the head sculpt, but for me, it's damn near Dolph Ziggler in real life. I mean, I like it a lot, and I like the attire, even though probably should have been the Chase variant. We should have got the pink version as the regular, version, but, it is what it is. What can you do, Brad? Good-looking figure nonetheless. Next, guys, we do have the Ringside Exclusive 2-in-1 Elite, which is the Undertaker posing as Kane. Also, Kane figure, I have it as a Kane Elite with the long sleeve here, and we did get a basic like this from Mattel, but I had to include it into this year's video. I just think this is such a good-looking figure. After we got the Elite 12, and then we got the Hall of Champions, to have it re-released again, but have the sleeve added is so beautiful, man. Such a good-looking figure. I know it has some, details on the mask that are missing that are kind of upsetting, but they really do need to give us a new Kane head sculpt. That is something I will say. We need a new Kane head sculpt to make it a lot better, but it is a great looking figure. Had to include it in my top figures of 2019. We have another Elite 70 figure in the house, and it is EC3, which I did switch out the thighs and make it, white boots EC3, but it still looks good in white tape and everything like that, but I like it a lot. It's one of those figures that's actually really cheap on Ringside, guys. If you missed out on EC3, I think it's like $9.99 on Ringside right now. Go use promo code MDTOYS. You'll save even more money on it, and you can pick up a big order. I actually made a big order yesterday, so I'm excited for that to come in. Got a lot of custom parts and stuff coming in, so stay tuned for that video. But this is epic, man. I like the EC3 figure. Treated like trash on TV, but his figure was not treated like trash. Another figure, guys, is the Elite 71 Drew McIntyre. Is this the Elite 71? I think it is the Elite. Yeah, it's the Elite 71, because his first figure had like that weird neck thing, right? And this one has the interchangeable head. Yeah, this has the interchangeable head. Really good looking Drew McIntyre. I think they made it a lot better than his first go around, just like they did with some other figures. They fixed it the second time around, did some tweakage, and the re-release is a lot better. I like this figure a lot, and I used to want to switch out the torso, but now I like this torso, dude. I like this torso a lot. I like the accessories we get and the cloth, and then you get, not cloth, but you get the hair in the face and everything, so good looking Drew Mack. Next up, guys, we have one of the Ghostbusters Elites, and this is the only Ghostbusters Elite that I actually included. I thought that this was the better one, and so I went with the Undertaker Elite with the all purple. I just love the way this looks. It looks so good. The translucent purple plastic is so nice, and then you get the interchangeable. You get the hat that you can take on and off. It's not, I guess it is interchangeable, but that's not the word that you want to use there. It's not head sculpts or anything, but I did want to include this Undertaker figure. Great looking figure, and I did want to narrow it down to one of the figures in the set. I felt like the John Cena or the Shawn Michaels could also make the list, but I narrowed it down to just the Undertaker. Next up, guys, is the Ringside / NXT / Target Exclusive / Ringside / Loose Torso figure, Andrade, but mine actually does not have that problem that everybody else has had, so I am very fortunate and blessed and have favor that this one did not have that problem. But this is a great looking figure regardless. The head sculpt is nice. I hate the new Elite 74 compared to this. I think that this is a much better torso in my own, personal opinion. I like these arms better. I like the just overall formula for this figure a lot better than the Elite 74 Andrade. We are going to do a comparison when we get the Elite 74 Andrade, and we do our review of it. We will do a little detailed comparison view, but I think I'm gonna like this one a lot more. The white attire and the torso and everything. That one does come with a cloth goods jacket, but this one is just excellent, dude. Next, guys, we have another WrestleMania 35 Elite, and it is the WrestleMania 19 Triple H. And again, I could not remember if this was 2019 or not, or if it was 2018, but nonetheless, I like this figure a lot. I already had a custom coming into the year of this figure, but I am glad that Mattel gave it to us, even though it's like a re-release of the Fan Central. I love the different types of Triple H. Hopefully we get some more different stuff from Triple H from that time period. I'd like to see his black like trunks look, that looks like sliding shorts. I'd like to see that figure next, so hopefully we get that one. Next up, guys, we do have the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive Macho Man Slim Jim figure, and this one's really nice. This one was given to me by Mattel, and I am very fortunate and blessed for that. I love this figure to death. I was bummed when it first came out. I was like, it's not the greatest exclusive, but I after, owning it a while and checking out the cool accessories, a great jacket, it, and you know, you get the flimsy whimsies coming off of it, the fringe, and it's basically a re-release of the Elite 38, but I enjoy it a lot. I put it up on the shelf and it looks good up there, so I'm happy to own this one and I wanted to include it. Next, guys, is the Elite 73 Kyrie Sane figure, one of the most recent pickups in our collection. I must knock the camera over, no big deal. I love this figure. You know, it did come in at number 3 in the Elite 73 ranking, so I thought that, you know, it had to be included here. If Elias, the worst figure, is included, then the third best in the set had to be included as well. And I think the full wave of Elite 73 is featured, so that just tells you how good Elite Series 73 is. And Kyrie Sane is one of those women's figures that made the cut. Next is the Elite WrestleMania 36 Matt Hardy figure in the white. I did do a head swap on it, but I did like this figure a lot. Not too much to cover, but I did want to include it. I thought that whole wave was pretty solid. I think we have 3 figures from that wave included, so Matt Hardy is one of those figures. You got the House Hardy on the back, man. Just terrific. Next is 4 Elite Series 69. No, that's Elite Series 67, you jackass. We have 3 Elite Series 69 Elites featured here, guys. You have The Miz, Bobby Lashley, and Ricochet, and all 3 of these figures are pretty damn perfect. You know, I think Mattel does an excellent job on their sets now. It's like, we don't ever get that many, but like, we'll get like 1 to possibly 2 bad figures a set. Like, that's like the most, if that even happens. Most of the time, it's just a release that we're like, eh, like, do we need that? And usually, they knock the ball out of the park anyway, and that's the case with these. I love the, you know, Ricochet figure. Even though, you know, the parts choices aren't the best, I love the torso, I love the head sculpt, and it's Ricochet, had to be included today. Bobby Lashley, I know I did fix it up a lot and change a lot of parts, but even standalone, I thought it was great with the head sculpt and everything you get. And then the Miz, this is the best Miz Elite that we've gotten to date, so it had to be included as well. Just a really, really strong figure, excellent looking stuff, and I had to include the Miz with the haircut and everything. And it's the WrestleMania attire, man, just Iron Man colors going through. Strong looking figure. My God, we still have a lot more to cover. I'm knocking shit over. This video is probably going to be longer than I thought. Moving right along, guys, we do have the Elite Series 69 Mustafa Ali, and we do have both versions right here, guys. We have the yellow version, which is the regular, and then we have the Chase variant red version. Found both at retail, and so I would say this figure is not as hard to find. I don't know if you guys have seen it in your area, but this one was actually really easy to track down, and it's probably been the only, besides the Elite 63 Shelton Benjamin, Chase variant that I've been able to find in store. So that is just something to take note of right there. And the head sculpt is a little bit too big. However, I really like the Mustafa Ali. I love Mustafa Ali. I think he's a fantastic talent, and his figure is damn good. You know, could they have given him a different torso? Maybe, but not the biggest deal to me. I still love it. I think it works perfectly. And if only the head sculpt were smaller, it would probably be a damn just freaking perfect. But nonetheless, it's a fantastic figure that had to be included here in 2019's top figures. Next, guys, we do have Elite Series 72 Buddy Murphy. This is the regular version, and another figure that's regular version is better than the Chase variant. The Chase variant is obviously in the black shorts. I prefer the red shorts, I think, in my own personal opinion. And I just love all the good things going on with this. I love the parts choices they used. I love the new molds of the shorts and the crotch piece. I like the kick pads, the white lower legs, the knee pads. Just, you know, it's just one of those figures that just makes you happy to collect, man. It's just one of those figures that you love to look at. And Buddy Murphy is definitely up there, dude. Just an excellent looking piece. Just, God in heaven. Got the on the ass cheek. I mean, God in heaven. Next, guys, we do have another Elite Series 73 figure, and it is this Daniel Bryan. And I actually talked to Brad about it, and he said the same thing as me. He said, yeah, dude, you need to paint those eyes. I don't know what it is. I haven't seen anybody else mention it, but the eyes are too light. It makes him look like a ghost, but it's still a great figure. It looks just like Daniel Bryan. I just think that the eyes need to be darker. If the eyes were darker, I think that it would be a perfect rendition of Daniel Bryan, even though it really is. I mean, it's perfect anyways. The eyes do need to be darker, but we do get the Hemp Championship. I love the attire, that heel Daniel Bryan, and this one could not be left out. Next, guys, we do have a few more figures up here. I'm going to go ahead and stack them up so we can get them all in frame here. We do have the Elite 71 Adam Cole. With the screaming head sculpt, you get the Adam Cole Bebe hands, you get the t-shirt. I know the NXT title's not included, and it's not the most impressive attire, but it's still a damn good figure. I did switch out the legs and everything, but I love it regardless. Adam Cole, one of my favorite talents in the world, and just this dude has absolutely torn it up this year, man, and just to capture it in this figure is perfect. It's just a great figure, and I don't know which one I like better. Do you like the Elite 71 or the Epic Moments 3-pack? Let me know down in the comment section below. Next, guys, we have a couple Top Talents figures, and it is the Top Talents 2019 Finn Balor and the Top Talents 2019 AJ Styles, and I will say that the one on the left is straight out of the packaging, the Finn Balor, and I will say I'm not big on the head sculpt, but I still like the attire. I like everything else going on with the figure, even though it may not be perfect. It's still one of my favorite figures, at least from a Finn Balor standpoint. I just love the silver. Gives us a lot of different creativity, you know, type deals going on with it. And then we have AJ Styles, who does not have that, you know, he's not supposed to have this head sculpt. There's actually a couple AJ Styles in this video that, you know, are not supposed to have this head sculpt. They're supposed to have the Elite 66 head sculpt, but they do not, and it's because of fix-ups and stuff. So just imagine that the good head sculpt's on this, and you have a damn good-looking top talents AJ Styles figure. And the Finn Balor, you do a head swap with it. I mean, it's perfection. Next, guys, we have a couple Elite Series 67 figures. We have the Velveteen Dream, and I know that, you know, when it's right out of the packaging, it has the massive Triple H torso, but I had to include it anyways just because it's Velveteen Dream. I think everything else about it is perfection. And then we have the Elite 67 Rey, and again, those modern Reys, I did leave out the Elite 69 Rey, but I did include the Elite 72 and the Elite 67 because of how good they are, so don't kill me because I left out that Rey. I did want to include these two because I found them a little bit more superior, but Velveteen Dream, even though the torso sucks, I wanted to include it because I switched mine anyway, and it looks good. Next up, guys, we have Elite 66 Kurt Angle, and this one is a little bit fixed up. You know, I do have the head scan missing at the moment. The head scan on it is trash anyway, but the rest of the figure, like the new mold we got for the torso and everything, and then, like, I did lower leg swap it, but even with his wrestling boots, it's still really, really good. Comes with the graps, you know, Captain America-style hands and everything, but I wanted to include Kurt Angle. Next, guys, we do have Elite Series 68 Daniel Bryan, and we thought the Elite 68 Daniel Bryan was great until we got the Elite 73, but the Elite 68 is still a really good figure. I still wanted to include it. Great Seahawks attire, great head sculpt for the time, and just a really strong blue attire. You know, it breaks it up from all of his red, gray, and black figure, so I wanted to include Elite 68. We have the Ringside exclusive two-pack Brood Hardy Boys, guys. I did order another pack of these from Ringside for the Black Friday sale because I did want to have this for some different fix-ups and stuff, so I did want to pick up another two-pack, but standalone, they're great. You know, we get the Brood shirts, you get the shirtless Hardy Boys, you get these nice black sleeves going on for both of them. I love both the head sculpts they got going on. While I like Matt's better than Jeff's, I still think they're really strong elites nonetheless. Probably said nonetheless about 600 times, but getting into Elite Series 73 again, we do have Grand Metalik, which I think is a really strong figure, and I think this came in at 5th or 4th on the list of the best to worst or worst to best in all of Elite Series 73. The parts choices on this are great. I think, you know, standalone, it's a perfect looking figure. I'm not huge on Grand Metalik, but I know he is a very talented luchador and cruiserweight wrestler, and he's really good, man, so I did like this figure a lot. I like the colors going on, the parts choices, you get the Sin Cara parts going on, and you have so many different things you can do with these. Next up, guys, is the Chase variant Dolph Ziggler, and I do have my custom, like, black hoodie on there just because I used it for the entrance on MDT Live, but then I didn't even include the entrances, so I did want to just leave it on there. I just think he looks really, really good. So you have the Chase variant Dolph Ziggler, and this is so much better than the regular version. Just the freaking pink tights, dude. Look at it. Just look at it. And so the custom hoodie with this head sculpt and the smaller arms and the painted boots on the outsoles, I mean, dude, this is one of my favorite figures of the year. This is definitely going to be on that top 10 countdown. At least looking at it right now, it looks like it's going to be on that top 10 countdown. We'll have to see, guys. Let me know again if you want to see that top 10 countdown of Elites of the Year. Next, guys, we do have a couple Jeff Hardy figures, and honestly, I didn't know if I wanted to include the Elite 67 Jeff Hardy in this countdown or in this top figures of the year, just because we've gotten so many Jeffs, and I felt like the Elite 67 was the weakest of the ones, but it's still a really good figure. I love the sleeves and everything. It's just the head sculpt that I'm not big on, but I still love everything about the Jeff. And then this Survivor Series Jeff is one of my favorite figures of the year. I know it hasn't hit retail yet, but I still have to include it in 2019 because so many people have it in their collections now, and I have two or three of them now, so I did want to include it, and it's just so good. The head sculpt, man. The head sculpt is just perfection. What are you gonna do, brother? What you're gonna do, brother, when Survivor Series Jeff Hardy runs wild on you? Coming into the final figures, guys, we are getting there. I can see the ending. We do have the WrestleMania 36, WrestleMania 19 Booker T Elite, and this one is very strong. I love this one to death. You get five-time hands, white attire, great-looking head sculpt. Had to be included in the video. Another Elite 73, guys, is the Elite 73 Aleister Black. Compared to his NXT figure, really strong. You get the spiked knee pads and kick pads. Still haven't switched out those lower legs yet. Still trying to figure out exactly what I want to do. I haven't switched out the wristbands either because I'm still doing other things, and I'm trying to film Hell's Gate and get to the Vindication Chamber. So when I get to the Vindication authentication chamber. That's probably when I'll switch it up and get it fixed. But this Elite Aleister Black is so good with the horned vest and the spiked stuff and the silver and the gray and the hey, it hurts me. We have the Elite 66 Bludgeon Brothers, and this is not the head sculpt that came on Rowan, but I did want to include these anyway. I thought these were really good figures, even though they're not very poseable and everything. I still think they have really good head sculpts. Again, this isn't the right Rowan head sculpt, but, you know, just shut the hell up and listen. I thought that all the details that they put into these figures and, you know, everything like that, I felt like they deserved to be on the top figures of the year. Again, they're not very poseable. Like, the legs are pretty damn stiff. They can't move around that well. I still wanted to include Harper and Rowan. Okay, I can finally see the floor, guys. We have my boy Cedric Alexander. You know he had to be included. Even with the ripped up torso being taken from us from Mattel, I still like this figure a ton. It's one of my favorite figures to pose around and play with and stuff like that, so I had to include Cedric Alexander. I did customize it a little bit with the shoes and everything, but I still love it. Just such a dope-ass figure, dude. Just really clean. Love Cedric Alexander, so had to include it. We have the Elite 65 Eric Young and the Elite 65 Roman Reigns. I know you're thinking, well, Brad, that's not the red vest Roman Reigns. Yeah, it's because I painted it because he got drafted to SmackDown, so I figured change it up a little bit. I do have a red version that I ordered, and I just wanted to include the blue version here, so I put the Elite 65 Roman in here with the blue. I did also switch out the arms for some other arms, but it's still the Elite 65 Roman base, and this Eric Young figure did give us like new boot molds and stuff. While the torso is probably a little bit too jacked for him, I still think all the details and stuff, this Sanity Eric Young figure look great, so I included both of these. Another Elite 65 figure that we included, guys, is Rusev Day. We actually included both of them, and while the Aiden English torso isn't exactly accurate for me, I still included it. I know I did have to repaint my head sculpt on my Rusev. I just love this Rusev, dude, with the Machka. I wish it said Rusev Day on the boots, but I'm not going to deduct any football points. We do have this beautiful Aiden English head sculpt, and it is the Chase variant version. I like this a lot. I thought both of these figures were really good, dude, so I had to include them. Elite 65 was the first set of the year, and I thought they did a solid job. You know, there were a couple busts in that set, but I wanted to include them anyway. We have a couple figures from Elite Series 66. We have the Chase variant Elite 66 Kevin Owens. I did not include the blue version just because I have the tattoos on there, and it has like some fix-ups on it, so I did want to include the Chase variant because it's the most stock Elite 66 Kevin Owens version that I have, but it is the KO Mania. And then we have the Elite 66 AJ Styles, which has the you know, the top talents or whatever head sculpt switch on there, and it does have different kick pads, but again, just imagine the Elite 66 head sculpts on there because it looks a whole lot better than this. But yeah, I still have to do some other things and get some more AJ Styles figures in here to fix those up. And then finally, we are on the final three, guys. I know it was a long video, but I hope you guys stuck to the end. We have the Entrance Greats Elias. I know it's not as good as his newest version, but I like the white pants, and you put the Hawaiian shirt on there. It's a really good figure anyways. We have the Elite 67 Randy Orton, which is probably the best Randy Orton to date. You have those, you know, torso tattoos added, and it's a great head sculpt. You get the interchangeable Randy Orton pose hands. And then finally, we have the Elite 73 Triple H figure, and the bearded head sculpt is fantastic, and the tights are fantastic. It's just a standalone, great-looking Triple H Elite, and that does it for our WWE Elite top figures of 2019, guys. I mean, mercifully, Jesus Christ, there were so many figures to include, and now that I've gotten through the video, probably should have narrowed it down a little bit better, but you know what, Brad? We made it to the end, and I hope you guys did enjoy it anyways, and if you guys stayed all the way to the end, then I want you guys to hit me down below with a My Damn Best of 2019 down in the comment section below, so hashtag My Damn Best of 2019 down in the comment section below. I really, really appreciate it. If you guys watched all the way to the end, you guys are absolute beast modes. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. In December, we do have a lot of long videos. I mean, like, it's going to be a lot of long videos. Like, we're going to have the room tour. You guys know we upload the room tour the day before the last day of 2019. We're going to do our collection video update where I'll show you my entire collection. Like, I'll pull up every figure one by one up to the camera, tell you what figure it is, maybe a brief description. That video takes an eternity to film. I mean, my God. That video will probably be 2 hours long. Not to mention Hell's Gate once it is finally finished, which I'm still not even close to finish with, so don't even ask. December is a really, really busy month for me, but it will be worth it once we get it all finished, guys. But that does it for the best WWE Elite figures of 2019. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, again, comment down below, hashtag MyDamnBestOf2019. I hope you guys subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE action figure videos and other epic stuff coming to the channel soon. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys for just great great shit. Subscribe again. Follow me. I said that already. And I think that is going to do it for today's video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.